Hello everyone. Today we're going to be replacing the fuel filter on this six-cylinder turbo diesel Mercedes Sprinter, and I'm going to record everything in one shot so you can see that it's not as bad as the dealer makes you think it is. And I'm a pretty quick wrench, so I'm going to start right in here. I'll tell you the tools that we need as we go along. Here's our flathead screwdriver. We're going to remove the air hose there. Unplug our mass airflow sensor and this other sensor over here. There's a clip underneath that we pop off, and we set that aside. The air cleaner, you pull the air inlet hose out there. It's 20 degrees out in northern New York today, so the rubber doesn't come apart as easily. You're gonna pop these grommets in the front of the air box, and on the right, you're gonna push a clip in and lift the 12-volt power wire that goes to the battery and set it aside. And there's our air box. Our next operation is to remove the turbocharger inlet pipe. And there is one band clamp that goes onto the turbocharger. Just loosen that band clamp with your flathead screwdriver and remove, and you can just set it aside like that. Okay, next. In front of the fuel filter is this bracket. I suspect that this is an anti-knock sensor. We're gonna grab our ratchet. It's a Torx bit. Let's see, I think it's this one here. And we'll remove that. You do want to have a safe place to keep all your nuts and bolts as you move along here. I generally keep a can off to the side, but today I'm just going to use the ground in the garage. Okay, longer one is on the right. And then we move, we have to unclip it from this coolant hose underneath, carefully. So we can move it out of the way. And there, now we have a better view of the fuel filter. Now, the fuel filter is held in with a clamp, and there's one bolt back here. I need to get a male Torx bit, and it's been a while. It's been a little while since I've done this. Okay, I'm gonna need the next one up, and I can tell you the exact size. Let's see, this is a T30. And that seems to fit. And we're going to loosen that T30 a few turns. Now the angle is going to be a little bit tricky, but you can actually do it with a 3/8 drive. You just have to loosen it enough to loosen the filter canister itself. Let's see, that should be enough. Let's check. Well, yeah, that's pretty loose. Okay, I'm just going to give it another turn just to make it easier on myself. Okay. We'll get our other tools out of here. Now, on the side here is the water, I believe it's what we call a water drain. And what I've done is there's a little clip that goes over the pipe. The original one was made out of plastic, and they always break. And the only way to get a new one from Mercedes is with an entire hose, of course. So I actually, let me remove my clip here and my hose. Oh, I better get a rag because there might be some residual diesel in there. I took the plastic clip out and I made one here out of a paper clip. It does the same job, but sometimes there's a little diesel left in the hose and I don't want it dripping all over the engine. So I'm going to take this rag and collect as much of that diesel as we can. And some might drip, but usually it doesn't. But I did warm the engine up today. Okay. All right. I think, well, still dripping a little. I'll just put this over the hose. Okay. Nextly, the diesel heater, the preheater, comes with the fuel filter. You push down on the clip on top, and it's a little tight, and pull that plug right off your preheater. And I'm just going to check the camera to make sure you can still see all this. Oh, kind of can't. Move it over here. Actually, I'll unhook it. All right. So here is the hose, the drain hose, that I've disconnected from there. This is the diesel preheater, and here's the plug that I removed from that. Next, we're going to take a small screwdriver and pop the clips like that on our two fuel lines. And no matter what anyone tells you, the clips are reusable. Now, you don't have to worry much about spilling fuel because the system drains itself. There might be a little bit left in one of the lines, but the system does drain itself. So I'm gonna put us back up in my little phone clip here. And sometimes you can twist these hoses off. Sometimes you can pull back and wiggle. Imagine rubber sticking to something and not wanting to come off. Sometimes ease it back a little with a flathead screwdriver, as I'm doing right now in the front of the hose. And you want to ease these hoses off as carefully as you can. Now, I'm in the middle of nowhere. I'm in the Adirondack Mountain region of New York State. And to say that there is a Mercedes dealer up here, there really isn't. The closest is in Vermont, which is over a two-hour drive, going a distance of 20 miles, because I would have to take a ferry. But I'm not rushing here because I really, really don't want to destroy these hoses, because I would have to go to a dealer for them. Now I'm thinking to myself, wow, I really put them on well. I could probably make a tool to ease these hoses off the fuel filter. But if you just go around the tip of the hose, the end of the hose, with your screwdriver and push back just a little bit, it is possible to ease it off. I bet Mercedes has a tool for this. So, while I struggle here with this hose that came off so easily last time, we can talk about how much Mercedes charges for this service. Now, oh, there goes hose number one. No spillage. We'll just pull hose number one out of the way, and I'll just bring the camera down again so you can see what I've done. Here's the hose. I pulled it off that fitting right there, and that's the next one that I need to remove. I'll put the phone back in its clamp. All right. Now we can do the second one. Now, we are quite a ways into this operation, and it didn't take me too long now, did it? And that's including the time I've struggled to remove that first hose. And there goes our second hose. That is disconnected. And I'll take the phone back. My phone camera, show you what I've done. There's the second hose. These clips are reusable. So now that everything's loose, we're gonna pull our filter right on out. Isn't that beautiful? Check that out. And look at the time. I'm gonna set it down on the ground. Here are my tools that I've been using. Okay, and my clip that I made out of a paper clip to hold on the water drain pipe and my two bolts for what I suspect is my knock sensor. So, let's grab the new filter. Yes, I'm doing this with one hand, like a real Mercedes tech. Okay, these filters are made by Mann, M-A-N-N. I suspect you can cross-reference the model and order the Mann filter, but I went with the original Mercedes package just because. We're gonna pop our caps off here. You don't want any dirt getting in there. I have to put the camera back down. Here we go again. All right. Maybe I can do this in front of the camera. What I like to do is save these caps and put them on the old filter in case there is any residual in the filter. I can just put the caps on there to keep the stink down in the garage. And we're going to insert the new filter back down where it goes. And I'm going to grab the phone. I'm going to put our drain back on like that. And grab my, I'm so proud of this, my homemade wire clip. And I just put it right in the slot on this drain hose. It's so darn handy. And it clips just like that. Very German. And there's our harness plug for the heater. And our fuel lines. I'm gonna push them on like that. I can't believe I'm doing this. It's high time that I've gotten around to doing this, because my gosh, the dealer charges so much. One time I went into the dealer and they said, well, it'll be, you know, anywhere from $287 to near $700 to do this. And I'm looking at my video timer and I'm only 14 minutes in here, folks. This isn't too bad. And we use our pliers on this. Whoops, I am doing this with one hand. Just squeeze the clip until it snaps. Ah, German cars are fantastic. I really love German cars. They're so well thought out. And I'm not saying that because I'm part German. Yes, I am. And that I'm working on it with one hand, which is like amazing. Okay, that clip is in. Wow, 14 minutes and 45 seconds here. Pick up my screwdriver. Wow, just like in the Haynes manual. I'm gonna grab doing it with one hand. It's like if I had one hand tied behind my back. I feel like some sort of Mercedes diesel superstar. We're tightening up our fuel filter clamp, and then after everything is back together, I'm going to start the engine and check for leaks, which I'm not going to do in this video because I need my other hand here to hold the ratchet. I'm not going to do it in this video because you won't be able to hear me talk. Okay, the fuel filter is secure. Let's see, I can put all these little bits and pieces in the box away. I don't need my rag, but I see there's a little oil residue on the inside of the turbocharger. Just gonna wipe that out. Now we're gonna put our turbo inlet hose back on. Let's see. And we're going to tighten the band clamp. Let's talk more about Mercedes-Benz service. You know, this is a work truck, okay? This isn't an S-Class, an S550, you know, $120,000, $130,000 luxury car. This is a work truck. It's incredibly well made. It's the best out there, as far as I'm concerned. I don't care what anyone else says. You look at the American products, they can't touch this. Impossible. They couldn't touch it if they tried. And that is an opinion. Now I'm going to put this sensor back on top. Again, I don't know what the sensor is. It's probably a NOx sensor having to do with the fuel injection system timing. A little tricky to put this clip on. Maybe next time I'll take the plug off the sensor. But there, the hose is back in its little cradle. Gonna grab my bolts. Remember, the longer one goes on the right. My Torx bolts. Wow, we're almost done. This is crazy. Well, anyway, I skip all over the place. So, when you bring your car in for service at Mercedes, you're gonna sit for a while. More than just a while. You're gonna be sitting for like an hour, unless they're a really good Mercedes dealership, waiting for them to just pull your truck into the service bay. And then you're gonna have the lowest pay grade mechanic working on your truck. You know, 21-year-old kid. They're gonna leave grease everywhere, and it's gonna get you upset. There, it's installed. Now let me get my air cleaner and put that back on. Today is also an oil change day. I should put on a tuxedo because, well, it's 20 degrees out. Yes, I'm doing this in 20 degree weather and my air box is making my garage beep. Sorry about that. But to change the oil in these, why is the garage light beeping? To change the oil in one of these is ridiculously simple. I can do it in a tuxedo without even lying on my back under the truck. It's that easy. The oil's $100. And look, I'm wasting all this time talking to you. Let's get that air box back in. So yeah, you put the tails of the air box on its mounting yokes in the back, which it's easier to do if I take this little snorkel off the side there. Okay. And then you click the front of the airbags into your front grommets and grab your proper Craftsman screwdriver and tighten your air inlet band clamp onto the mass airflow sensor. Wow, I could do all sorts of operations on the Sprinter. I could be the Bob Ross of Sprinter repair, because this is so easy. My 12-year-old could do it, and I mean that. She's pretty smart. Clip this back on. put our snorkel on here, click it back into the air filter housing. This is also a good time, I mean, I checked it 10,000 miles ago, but this is also a very good time to take your bolts off the air cleaner housing and check the condition of your air cleaner. And my gosh, that's it. There's our new fuel filter installed, and my video is 20 minutes and 28 seconds. And that's jabbering like an idiot, telling you about how much I despise Mercedes-Benz's hourly rate for working on these things. I mean, these are built better than any domestic product. Have you ever looked at an engine on a Ford or a Chevy? I mean, really? Come on. Really? Look at how well laid out this is. And you can actually shove your hands down in there and not have to disassemble a ton of stuff. This is why a lot of those 70s and 80s Mercedes diesel vehicles are still in service. I mean, for, you know, obviously enthusiasts have to take care of them, but they're pretty easy to work on. And the only thing that I have to work on this, I needed to get a Bluetooth OBD tool so I could read the codes on my cell phone. And I actually had to fight with the Mercedes dealer over the EGR valve, which is here. The EGR valve is one of the weakest points in these engines. And what I do is I unbolt it, lift it up, spray it with some carb cleaner and a toothbrush every 15,000 miles, and that keeps it from gumming up and faulting. And what it was faulting, and I just got tired of it. I'm like, you know what? I've been cleaning this thing since day one. Every 10 to 15,000 miles, I've been cleaning it. And this has been dead reliable. Now I'm at about 110,000 miles. And this is its second EGR valve. The first one, the servo motor, just, it got tired. That's one of the problems with EGR valves. And this is water-cooled, the EGR valve. And there is a gasket underneath, which you should replace religiously every time you do the service. But it'll keep that surprise of the vehicle bucking on you when you're on a road trip during shifts when the EGR is gummed up and it makes the engine hiccup. Again, the weakest part of the Mercedes Sprinter turbo diesel van is when they put the AdBlue system into it, and it just added an additional complication that fails. It is something about the service duty of the doser valve and the nitrous oxide sensors. Whatever. That's for another video, but thank you for watching. Oh, wow, 22 minutes and 46 seconds. If you brought this to a dealership, 22 minutes is how long it takes to get your car parked and walk in the freaking door and give them your name and information and cringe when they tell you, oh, it's $500 to do this. And you just watched me do it in about 20 minutes while talking, and that's just crazy. Thank you for watching. And I'll try to make other Sprinter videos in the near future. But right now I'm going to move on to my oil change. And who knows, maybe I'll videotape that too. All right, bye-bye.